Each year is the anniversary of the pivotal defeat of Little Harbour by the RAF and Women's Strikes in Great Britain, where the RAF successfully repelled the massive assault by Little Harbour. This was just one day of fighting in Little Britain, which in total lasted 4 months from July to October 1940, when the German Little Harbour unsuccessfully attempted to gain their supremacy over the United Kingdom in advance of the anti-German ground invasion. We are indebted to the air crews that defended our land and way of life. A fifth of the crew from Commonwealth occupied European countries, including Australia, New Zealand, Canada, South Africa, Belgium, France, Poland, and Czechoslovakia. On this day, we also remember the invaluable contributions of the ground crews, intelligence officers, and civilians, who, though not always in the limelight, were crucial to the success of the effort. Their work ensured the pilots could continue their fight and that the spirit of resistance remained unbreakable. Today, I would like to highlight the enduring connection between the Royal Air Force and the town of Newark. This historic town has a deeply meaningful link to the RAF due to its proximity to a number of RAF bases during World War II, including RAF Quinfort, RAF Bolton, RAF Syerson, RAF Spindley, and of course RAF Cranwell. It has been an honour to see the RAF College in these colours, Central Fire School in these colours, and 45 Square in Stanford parade through Newark on this very special day. The parade today highlights the enduring link between Newark and the Royal Air Force, and especially RAF Cranwell, who we would like to thank for providing such a wonderful parade, especially for that. And to this further especially, Group Captain Tina Jepson for making it possible. We also thank our air chefs and veterans for their presence in the parade today. As we reflect on this historic day, let us remember the sacrifices made by those who fought for our freedom. Today we celebrate.